In September 2017, I finally landed at Quito, Ecuador. I was going to explore a dream that had been with me for more than 20 years, the Amazon rainforest. By crossing the mountain Andes, I went all the way down into Amazon region. The landscape was changing from highland cloud forest to lowland rainforest, and the scenery was just magnificent. I arrived at my destination at around 8 p.m. It was about half a mile away from the place I parked my car to the basin I was going to live for the following days. There were a lot of amazing animals spotted on my way to the basin, such as moss mimicking katydid and various species of praying mantis, grasshoppers, and other small animals. This feeling inside my bones, it goes electric wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home, we're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Myself actually live inside of the Palma forest when I woke up in the second morning. Christopher, the owner of the basin, has been living here for more than 20 years. And he's definitely an amazing and friendly person to be with, and I really love chatting with him. I finished my search pretty early last night because the heavy rain felt like bullets and just kicked me back. Christopher prepared all the food and meals that was way exceeded my expectation, and I have to say I love it. It is actually very difficult to look for animals during the day because there was just too much information going on and appearing in my vision, and the destruction is happening everywhere. But it was pretty good to just check the surroundings and to decide which direction I was going to when the night falls. So with the headlight, I was able to actually concentrate and focus on the spot I was looking at. So my searching schedule would be from 6 p.m. after the sunset to 2 a.m.
After 10 hours of searching on day 3 inside the jungle, I finally encountered the leaf mimicking mantis, which I think is a huge accomplishment for me because I have been a mantidaholic since I was only 5 years old. And just look at how beautiful that mantis is.
Complicated every single time.